All right, here we go. Right, left, left, right, left, right, left, right. Three, two, right, right. Three, two, left, left.
Gotcha.
Are you awake? Left, right. Three, two, left, left, right, right. Down.
Down?
There is no down. Let's right, left, left, right, left, right, left, oh right. God. Three, two, one, sink.
Oh, my God.
You know it's going to be the tag for this video. Yeah.
Right, 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 right.
Did you do it right, right? I don't know. Right, right. A Final Fantasy for fans and first-timers.
And also assholes who completed the game and want to take a victory lap in front of thousands of people.
Fuck you! Fuck, what does that mean?
That means we're gonna fucking beat this game again. What do you mean?
You just...
This is us being badasses at the top of the hill, looking
bonus
down
content
on the...
has been unlocked. Start playing the game and receive your gifts.
Is that DLC?
Yeah.
Okay. No, this is what this is all about, baby. This is about drinking in our victory. Soaking in. Going around with our nation's flag draped over our bodies and waving into the stands. Guys, Jirard completed Final Fantasy 15 almost.
I didn't. Okay, let me rephrase.
First off,
editors, do not, for this whole section, show the original Final Fantasy intro
screen.
No, don't do that.
Just show a giant picture of Ted instead of the logo for Final Fantasy 15.
We'll go back to the end of this Let's Play, but for now,
just
for the intro scene. Just or for this first screen
anytime
right here.
Anytime this scene is shown,
just put a big ass picture of Ted.
Just cover the entire image.
But
with Ted.
I just want to make sure, Ted, that if it's fucking out of focus or low res, you're fucking done.
People want to get a good look at you.
Anyways, so welcome, GameWisp exclusive series, Final Fantasy 15.
Thank you for paying for this.
This
is what you get.
We're
big ass HD pics of Ted.
We're gonna
look at him. Look at him.
This is what the fans want.
Look at him.
At this point, the fans on GameWisp love Ted more than
look
us.
Look at him.
Let's be real.
You just have to imagine. You just have to imagine we're looking at him. But you guys out there, look at this.
Look at this man.
Ooh.
I didn't see this special tab. I'm not going to click it. Anyways.
Spoiler tab.
I didn't. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So.
Here's actually what we're doing.
So. We are calling this Final Fantasy 15 a crushing story. And what this means...
Let's crush. It's not a let's play. It's a let's crush.
It's a let's crush, you guys.
Super Crush Bros.
Guys, Crush from Finding Dory is made his way into Final Fantasy universe.
Guys, Crush from Finding Dory is now the singer, the lead singer for Crush 40 the band, who have recorded a brand deal integration song for the drink Crush.
It's true. For Crush, the orange... Not fanta drink.
Yeah, in a sequel, an upcoming sequel to the movie Blue Crush.
I can't top
Kate
that. Upton.
No.
Game of Crush.
Final Fantasy Crush. Here we go.
So,
Final Fantasy 40.
What this means is while we are going to be playing for mostly story purposes, for mostly
all the
story
characters are going to be replaced with dolphins in this playthrough.
No. For story purposes, we are playing New Game Plus mode. So, in New Game Plus mode, none of the plot is ruined. And nothing is ruined in New Game
it's
Plus
mode.
It's
the same damn game, except
we're going to be level 99 with all of our gear. So,
lol.
That's where we're at. So, with that
we're going to
said,
stroll through this game as gods among men.
Yes.
New Game Plus allows you to carry over certain data
from previous playthroughs.
So, it's literally just... an easy, like a regular playthrough of the game, except we are the bosses of the world.
Yes.
God bless.
What was my most recent save? It must be this one.
Is the last chapter really called?
Don't say it. Not yet.
What? Is that really what the last chapter of this game is called?
Yeah.
Give me a break.
So as a warning, you all should watch Kingslave if you really want the full scope of this, but it helps a lot.
Not necessary, but it's a lot more immersive than most of the Final Fantasy worlds. If you watch Kingslave and if you watch, what's it called? Birthright? What is it called? The other one, the anime?
Brotherhood.
Brotherhood. There it is. Yeah, that's also pretty good. Not as good as Kingsglaive. And Kingsglaive isn't even that good, but it's awesome. And that's the thing that's important about Kingsglaive is that it's fucking awesome.
It's true. It is awesome.
It's so awesome. Dude, I'm not even going to spoil it, but there's like a character from Final Fantasy who hasn't been in a game in a while. Well, it's not that he hasn't been in a game, but it's just like a great cameo by like a classic Final Fantasy character.
Yeah.
I forgot that the game starts like this.
Yeah, it's kind of cryptic.
Dude, the fucking music in this game is fucking tight. Can you just win this time?
No.
What in the The graphics are so good.
Hang in there, buddy. Stay down. We'll keep him busy.
The funny thing about this is that this is weaker than we'll ever be.
Quickly, before he strikes again. Here comes.
That sick gun. Prompto's gun is like straight out of Destiny.
Here you go.
One of the best video games of all time. Is this a little too loud?
I don't care.
Fuck yeah. Good answer.
Before the fall.
If anybody's worried that these like weird like single sentence like black and white frames are going anywhere, it happens maybe like three more times in the whole game.
The decreed hour is come.
The sad thing about this is that in Kingsglaive, this character is played by Sean Bean.
True.
And it's weird that he's not played by Sean Bean in the game.
Your Majesty, take your leave and go in the grace of the gods. Right.
Yo, question of the day, is Prompto supposed to be high all the time?
No.
Are you sure?
He's not.
Look at his fucking face. Seriously.
He's not.
I want everybody to weigh in on the comments.
Princes will be princes.
He looks like he's stoned, for reals. Protocol.
Not like you had to deliver a formal address.
Your Highness!
What now?
This is like, if you watch Kingsglaive, this scene is like so much worse than this scene is.
It's true.
Like...
So for those of you who don't know, this is father and son right here.
Yeah.
King and prince.
He's like a good dad, and he's like a great king, and that's the vibe.
Indeed, Your Grace.
We'll see the prince to Alticia if it's the last thing we see.
Yeah, what he said. Hate to break this up, but Kor's got the motor running. Drados, he's in your hands.
And another thing.
Spoilers?
Your manners around your charming bride-to-be.
Spoilers.
Your Majesty as well. Try to mind yours around our esteemed guests from Niflheim.
You have no cause for concern.
Nor do you.
Take heed, once you set forth.
They're talking so soon after each other.
I would?
I need only know that you are ready to leave home.
I don't care.
I don't know about you, but I'm ready as I'll ever be.
Take care on the long road.
Dude,
wheresoever you should go,
this scene, man,
Lucis goes with you. Walk tall, my son.
There's a lot of subtext in that whole scene right there, but most of it stems down from we are seeing a man who just said goodbye to his son for the last time.
That's the main thing. The main thing is just that, like, Noctis is like a prince. You can tell that he's kind of like not all about that life of like being a king right now, but he like has to be one, and he's like committed to being one. And so this is him like going through this.
There
like
you go. Prince Noctis sets forth from his homeland with three of his three man
retinue
intel. His destination, Alticia, capital of Accordo, where he will formalize the union of states through his marriage to Lady Lunafreya of the Imperial Province of Tenebrae.
But what that basically translates to is that him and his bros are going to go on like one last road trip before he gets married and becomes like royalty, basically.
You could basically say it's like a bachelor party gone wrong.
Yeah, it's like...
But it's not really that. It's more about keeping the prince safe in order for... The union between the two Tenebrea and the kingdom is super important for the world.
Yeah, it's just like a Final Fantasy ass premise, which gives us the sort of like excuse to make a road trip Final Fantasy, basically. It's so tight. It's so tight.
So the Kingsglaive, the movie, or really the Kingsglaive's purpose, it's basically the king's army or like the king's protectors.
They're like Jedi, basically. They're like,
yeah, they're meant to protect the king and anything going forward. And so the movie is about the events that we're about to find out that unfold. But in the meantime,
this basically, if you watch Kingsglaive, it's basically happening at the same exact time as this first chapter of the game.
Yes. Yes.
They don't really have anything to do with each other until the very end of the chapter.
Maybe, how about this, for our Beer Bros fans, we will...
Oh, we'll do the movie.
We'll watch the movie after we play the game.
Tight. Yeah. Or we can do it for Game Wisp.
That's what I mean.
Yeah. Oh my god. Your regalia is still your regalia?
I think we can forget.
Oh my god, it's still my regalia.
Thought people were friendly.
Everybody's so well dressed.
You can only go so far.
Their costumes are still the same. Oh no.
You're just gonna have to push.
This is great.
I've already pushed myself to the brink of death.
This is great.
Get up.
So for you guys,
come on, car isn't gonna move itself.
These are their endgame costumes.
Yeah.
This is great.
I thought the car was supposed to move us.
Wouldn't that be nice?
Can it? Ready, steady.
This is fucking perfect. This is great. Now our video is gonna get taken down for copyright.
Yeah.
So we have to continue to talk over this part pretty extensively the entire time. What do you want to talk about?
Guys, this is probably one of the greatest renditions of Stand By Me, in my opinion. If any of you say Sean Kingston, you're dead to me.
Frankly, it's kind of a shame that we have to talk over and ruin this beautiful cover of this song, because unlike the shitty Sean Kingston cover, which sucks, this one is really, really good, and it is evocative of one of the best Final Fantasies that's come out in quite some time.
It's true.
Therefore, it is quite a tragedy that we are unable to listen to this wonderful rendition of the song.
I mean, you can hear it, but
you can somewhat hear it, but I'm definitely ruining it right now, and that's the thing that sucks about it. And I hate that I'm doing it, and I don't want to do it, but you know what? Just for you guys, I'm going to do it. I'm going to ruin it, because you know what I don't want to happen?
Copyright strikes.
I don't want to get this video taken down for copyright. I wouldn't do that to you guys.
It's true.
So instead, we're going to do this really annoying bit, and that's it. Basically, what's going on right now is that this car is broken down, and they're pushing it to the gas station in the next town.
They're trying to push it.
They're trying their best.
They're trying their best, while Ignis is just shit. So let's explain our teams.
Yeah.
Noctis, the prince.
Noctis is the prince. He's kind of like dark personality, but he's like a nice guy.
Yeah.
He's kind of like goth-ish.
A little bit.
Yeah. Not like satanic, but just like...
We have Prompto, who is moody. Like Noctis's youngest friend from when they were kids.
Uh-huh, and he may or may not be stoned all the time.
That's true, for your sake.
I'm just saying.
Then there's Gladio.
Look at his eyes. Just look at his eyes.
Look, I'm all with right. you.
Yeah,
I'm
just saying. They look... I don't know.
Yeah. No, I got you.
Then, Ignis is like the nerd butler, like
he's a butler slash cook.
He's like that anime archetype of like the nerd. You know, he's not like I'm a nerd, but he's like I'm a nerd.
Yeah, yeah.
And then
I'm a nerd.
And then Gladiolus is like the DPS.
He's the big boy.
Yeah.
Hey there, y'all kept a girl waiting. Now, which one's the prince?
I wonder why her name isn't Sydney.
Hello, Your Highness.
Sydney?
Because she's related to Sid,
not
right?
Hitch just yet.
Lady Luna Freya's groom to be here in Hammerhead.
So well dressed.
You best save your apologies for Pawpaw.
Well, that makes you.
Sandy. Sid's grease monkey granddaughter.
See, like.
Roll her in,
wouldn't it make sense that Sid's granddaughter, like
Sid Sydney,
it's like you know, she's like still Sid, but she's like also classic. Like it's a like a more feminine book. Name.
Mm-hmm.
Prince Noctis.
I love how much of an asshole this version of Sid is.
Prince, like they took your old man and kicked the dignity out of him.
What? Damn.
You got a long way to go, son. And that slackjaw's getting you nowhere fast.
Damn. Roasted. Yeah. Well, he was like, actually, this car looks really good. Have I been working on this for like 75 hours?
Y'all get her in and run along.
Where'd you get this? This paint looks like my handiwork.
Y'all heard him. Let's get moving. Right this way.
Yeah, right this way indeed. Man. So here's some expectation docs I want to set for everyone.
Sure.
We're not going to be doing every hunt.
No.
We're not going to be doing crazy hunting and stuff for the team. Mm-hmm. First off, just go ahead and take a look at our stats. Yeah,
hilarious.
We're definitely a little...
9999 HP.
Yeah.
Three of your weapons are the weapons that kill you.
Yeah. Well, okay, hold on. So first off, we got some new weapons.
What?
So I went ahead and I purchased, where is it?
Oh, the DLC?
I bought them, but they're not here. Maybe you buy them?
Where do you get them?
Hold on. Oh, maybe I don't have it yet. Oh no, here it goes. No. It's like the Final Fantasy. Oh yeah, they are here. Okay, cool. Oh man, they're just starting weapons. I see. So they're not that good.
What
That's
was
okay.
that?
What?
Was that a chocobo?
That was my phone going off. It's my text message.
Did you plan that for this
no,
Let's Play?
No, I didn't. I didn't. Okay, yeah. So in that case, I didn't go back in. My other game save file is further along in regards to some of the crazy shit we can get. But as for now...
So why did you choose this one?
What, this game save?
Yeah.
Well, because I can't like start the game... Like, this is... Right now is my current stats, right? As they are.
Yeah.
But when basically, I think what I'm going to do is by the time I get
to... Oh, you don't want to like destroy your old... Endgame file.
Yeah, because I've already put a lot of hours into it. I might considering, depending on how far ahead I've gotten, because I have to, my hunt level is level 0. All of my skills for like them is 0. Like if I go to their skills. Oh no, they kept them. Oh, then maybe I will
just keep
do that then. But they sent your hunts back to 0, which is the worst part. It looks like my guild though is definitely in good standing.
You have plenty of gil.
Yeah.
And you have plenty of AP.
Yeah, definitely.
But I think you're probably
so
already...
So my hunts are the only thing that are really gone, which kind of sucks, but I don't really mind that much.
Okay.
So with that said, let's go ahead and get everyone equipped. For the sake of this playthrough, we have some new things.
Oh my god. Please. Please.
I don't know if I can do that. Oh my goodness.
Please.
You want me to have the festive one?
At least for a while.
Fancy and fun outfit perfectly suited for enjoying the festivities increases maximum HP and MP. Well, I already have max, so it's a bit redundant.
That's his basic outfit.
Starting out, how about that? Starting out, we'll just have our basic outfits just for the fun of it. Let's see what else we got
well,
here.
Well, we
got
to see. Oh, did none of them get funny stuff?
I guess not, no. Those casual outfits, I don't...
Keeping it cash with Glad?
Yeah. Let's see, what about you? Let's see, what are your casual outfits? Yo, that looks pretty good.
Yeah, you look like some kind of model.
A jacket? Doesn't look like a jacket.
I don't see how that's a jacket.
Yeah,
I guess
don't
it's
either.
Like a thin
What about you?
Like a thin blouse, I guess.
What's Noctis's
cash?
Cash. This outfit right here
that
is the end
really
game
weird.
Content. This is the costumes you get
that's the DLC.
Now it's DLC, but before it was pre-orderable.
Oh yeah.
With the special edition one. That's how I have that one.
Which one does that do?
It's experience.
What?
And casual outfit is also there. It's not experience, sorry. It's
dude, Noctis in a hat is like no good.
You know what it does is it makes everything in half. Like buying gil and buying things, is 50% off, like when you're staying at the places to stay.
So the $300,000 hotel becomes $150,000?
Yep. Easy peasy.
Wow.
Pretty crazy, huh? So I think in terms of starting out, like all of our stuff's pretty good. These are some sexy boys. This is the boy band.
These are some sexy boys right here.
All right.
Woo! You know what? I'm changing this. We're RPing this. We're not going to our wedding anymore.
No, we're not RPing this shit.
Yeah, no, we're headed to prom instead. We're taking Lunafrey to prom. This will make sure y'all don't get lost. Look at that.
World map.
Tell me that guy's not dressed to go to like South Bay.
I'm with you.
California.
Yeah.
Like 2006 prom.
Well, might as well make.
I think I saw this guy at my prom.
So it looks like it wants us to go ahead and.
Whoa! They got Ebony out here. Oh, Ignis is gonna flip. Wait. What's a gill?
So, standard of how this game is.
Gosh, he looks so awkward when he's running like that.
I know, right? This is how the game works. X's jump.
If you've ever played like The Witcher or something like that, it's like more that kind of game than most Final Fantasies are.
Square. I can't run inside.
It's like GTA like. Almost. We've expended the last of our farms. There's like a big open world. I suggest we
confer with Cindy. Ignis.
Broken down. Yeah, it's a big open world, and you can go anywhere. It's gated a little bit just based on progression through the story.
So for right now, it's gated, but this is our world map.
Yeah.
This is a pretty big area.
It's pretty big, and there's a couple other areas.
Where is that fucking new DLC area?
I don't think it's a new DLC area. I think it's like parts of the game are like decorated and stuff.
Old man's in for both after charging us that.
Really?
I didn't get the chocobo post, maybe.
Let's pay him a visit.
I can't remember.
Is it a timed event?
Or maybe it's... Maybe it's Altissa.
Oh, we'll see. Be ready for a while. Y'all need
something? But the point is, you like go up to people, get missions, and then do the missions. And then like some of the missions are like the main story missions to progress the story forward. And then there's hunts you can do kind of like in Final Fantasy 13. Remember that?
Yeah.
Similar to that. Like you just like go out into the world and do a hunt and get stuff for it. And you grind them out to get items and stuff. I get it. This must be what Papa meant when he said. And you can like customize your car and you can like buy stuff and you can like grind for gear and like find gear. There's side dungeons and side quests and all these bosses. We're going to beat every boss. I'd be
happy to pay every boss?
Every boss.
Even like secret dungeons?
Let's do it.
All right. That's a pretty tall order, but if you say that
at the end of the game, if we get through it,
I will. How about this? Teach him not to underestimate. Every boss is fucking hard, Alex.
Well, because look, we don't have to do any grinding. Think about that.
Right.
We're just going to play the story.
It's right. And I will say the story will probably take us about a half an hour an episode, which is a episode worth.
That's what I'm saying. So, like,
in 13 episodes, we'll be done with the game.
We're going to be like...
Aside from the first few episodes.
We're going to be like grinding out bosses.
You're right. I'm not going to fight you on that.
It's going to be a normal length series, you guys. I swear to God.
So, with that said, let's talk about combat. Chop, chop, Prompto. Combat.
A robot.
So, this right now is our quest log.
Yeah, and it like fills up. It
fills up real fast, real quick.
This is also just like porn for people who haven't been able to play this game yet.
Yeah, so check this out. Here's our enemies. Oh my god, I know. I'm gonna warp strike in. That's one down.
Oh my god.
That's two.
This is so funny.
That's three. I failed the bonus mission, but that's okay.
What?
I failed the bonus mission.
So there's points around the battlefield that you can warp to, and when you get to those points, it refills your health and your magic and stuff. And so the point is that you kind of like get in and like do like little bursts of combat and combos by like you have like four weapons and you have like little like sort of like skills and stuff that you can get each one of your party members to do. It's a very streamlined, simplified version of like Final Fantasy style combat, except it's active, like an in-action game.
Now, I also forgot that I'm wearing a item that gives me infinite stamina, so that's why you don't see me ever stop running.
That's insane.
Yeah.
We're gonna beat this game so goddamn fast.
It's gonna be pretty quick.
Oh man, this version of this song is so good. But real talk, like, see how he's like going around? You can also dodge, but it's not like it's not like Devil May Cry. It's not like combo based. It's more about just like it's more like a fusion between like an action game. It's like what Final Fantasy Versus 13 tried to be, or Final Fantasy, what's it called? 13-3?
Right. Yeah.
Lightning Returns. It's like what that game tried to be, but it does it a lot better and a lot more intuitively.
So, to give you an idea, I have one trophy left.
Really?
One trophy.
What is it?
Collect all trophies is the last one. I have the last, like, mandatory one. And the last one is to reach maximum fishing level.
Oh, man.
So I need to fish a little bit.
A lot of bit. You're halfway. You're only halfway there.
Yeah, but a few couple of fish, like...
There's, like, rare ones that boost your fish up.
Yeah, it's like... fishing is...
There's a trick. If there's a trick to it, I will sit here and I will talk about fucking total bullshit the whole time while you fish. And we have to drink beer for those episodes.
Sure. Got it. So the biggest thing I love about this game is these four characters. Their chemistry together and their love for each other is... unbound like any friendship I've seen in the game.
Yeah, it's really interesting. Like, I remember when this game was first being announced, and even like into the cycle of it, like a large part of like the public sort of like zeitgeist about the game was that like it was kind of lame that, you know, after feminism has come so far in gaming in the last couple years, like, and like representation especially has come really far, you know, the new Final Fantasy doesn't have any girls, any female characters at all on the squad, except for like sometimes.
Who could this be?
But it's definitely more about these four people, right?
It's true.
And at the time, you know, and this is, I think, a more Japanese cultural thing than it is American or Western in any way. But like, he was like, you know, hold on, let's see. Reckon he staked out a spot
in an old shack nearby. Old shack. Oh, got it. We'll take a look.
So right now, Chapter 1 literally is designed as a means of showing us how to play the game, what missions mean. What did
Cindy say? Yeah, we're going to meet Dave. He teaches us how to hunt. But basically, real quick, just to finish what I was saying. Not missing. He was saying that, like, the relationship that you get between boys when there are no women around is something that you can't accurately portray when there are women around. Like,
so you're saying that they're... For the sake of this game, they purposely chose to not have any women in the group.
Yeah, they wanted to tell a story about
four brothers.
Like four men like bonding, like a sort of like unrepresented tenderness in this type of game.
Yeah.
You know? And it seems up to us to sort of decide how well they do that, but like to be honest, I think it's pretty good. Especially for a culture that's like not really about like being super affectionate with each other as men.
Yeah.
You know?
So, just, I also want to point out that Alex is only on chapter 9 of this game.
At this point,
so,
but I guarantee you, before we finish this, I'm going to, like, get so hype about it and just...
I hope so for your sake, because eventually we're just going to have to get to a point where...
Dude, literally, listen. We are, like, actually almost done with Pokemon Sun now. I'm going to crush that game in, like, 5 days. And then other than grinding that game, I'm going to get home, I'm going to want to play Final Fantasy 15. I'm going to play it for, like, another 100 hours. I've been dying to do it. So this is like you're like getting like tricked into doing your first hunt, kind of.
Kind of, yeah. I'm going all out.
Just calm down, dude. You're just like one hit killing everything.
They don't know any better.
Not good.
My hands. So if I can
I forgot that this happens. You're telling me that dude's not high?
No, he's not high.
Come on, dude.
The point of this game is, there's an empire that has gone around forcefully kind of taking over many lands. And Niflheim, which is the home of King Noct- or Prince Noctis, and, got a plan. It's funny, I don't remember the game giving me all these extra things, but maybe they did.
This, like, tutorial?
The challenge stuff.
Yeah.
So it wants me to perform a warp strike. Friends propose strategies to gain advantages in combat. Follow their strategies to earn AP.
That's the missions thing.
Yeah.
That's the challenges. How many times? Enough talk. Time for some action. I probably did it about a third of the time.
I didn't.
So you
do
go
it
to this thing
all.
And then you like, it helps you automatically lock onto an enemy and then you just warp strike to them. And it's how you kind of like move in and out of safety. And, like, kind of, like, focus on the parts of the battle that you need to focus on to, like, strategically take down your enemies.
Yeah.
It's pretty tight. Hey,
Who's out there?
I really like the battle system. I hated it at first, actually.
I was like, I was scared at first,
I was like
too,
raging.
But I picked it up quickly.
Yeah, I was raging at it for like the first 2 hours, but then I was like, yes.
Didn't mean to cause y'all any trouble. I've been stuck here on account of my sprained ankle. Yeah, something funny about them varmints. I gave them hell, but couldn't finish the job. Still, one.
This guy's like quest line in this game is like so morose.
It's weird. You'll find a lot of there's a lot of quests in this game you just find.
Yeah.
You know, I'll do it for free 'cause I'm nice.
Literally all of his missions are like somebody died.
Go find
their grave and bring it back.
Yeah.
I did not realize that it's like
way to show some spunk.
Like Jack Skellington style skull and crossbones on his jacket. Like when you look up close. That's so funny.
Mutant Marauder, look at the target.
It's like the Black Parade.
I knew you were gonna go there. Anyways, so the point of this game
is my favorite Creed song.
There's an empire that's taking over the land, and Niflheim is one of the few last remaining kingdoms.
It's like a huge like dick of an empire that's just like flexing and like bopping everybody, and it finally is like come to the shores, and they're like doing a deal.
And so in the midst of Niflheim, the king is obviously Noctis' father is the king. He's trying to peacefully not surrender, but like try and find a middle ground. And in fear of the future of their city, as a precaution, he sends Noctis away with these guys in case something goes wrong.
Right.
But more importantly, it's because they're trying to prepare him for his new life with his soon-to-be wife, Lady Lunafreya.
Right. That beautiful car
again. Sitting most of the day was pretty nice.
Over there. That's it, right?
Huh. That's a dual horn? Yeah.
What are you guys looking at? Oh, there he is.
We must make quick work of it.
Oh, you have the shield? That's tight.
I have all the weapons.
You got all of them?
I have all 12 of the King like of Kings weapons.
Yeah, they're like ancestral weapons, and like only a couple of them are like necessary on the quests.
You'll find out more about it in a little bit.
Yeah, it's tight.
Wait a sec.
What? Scared, big guy?
You ought to be too. Things vicious.
When I played this game, the team strategy things never came up.
They come up. It's just like, it's really hard to like notice, and it just happens for me about a third of the time. It's like practically automatic. Like barely even think about it. Yo, this looks really good. Talk about graphics right now. Look at that, dude. Slaughtered. You're getting that low finesse grade because you're just like bopping them too fast.
Well, here's the thing. So there are in the most recent DLC release of this game.
Hey, Dave just called and said he's safe. Thanks for finding him.
Ken.
Nice work, y'all. By the way, the old girl's looking good as new.
Yay!
Oh, well, I got ya. If y'all want to fix her up before you roll out, let me know.
Okay. What?
That's he left something in the trunk for me.
What? Did that happen?
I don't remember that part.
What the fuck?
But I think so.
Dad left something in the trunk.
She'll be
the fuck
the
is it?
Gotcha.
I forget.
What if it's like a double-barreled shotgun?
So,
who's up next behind the wheel?
This game has a day and night system.
And it's really tight.
Yeah, about a day is about 8 minutes worth of waiting in real time. I think it's eight minutes is like day, and then 8 minutes is night. So it's like 16 minutes a day, I think.
Is that really it?
Something like that, yeah.
I feel like it's longer than that, but maybe it's not.
But here, so let's talk about promises for this series, because hopefully you guys will watch it with us and we like it. We're going to essentially, one, beat the game.
Yep.
Two, I will try and attempt to beat each dungeon, but that's a big ask.
We'll see.
Three, at the very least, we will fight the Hellacious
Adamantus.
Adamantus.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
It's a 45-minute fight, or it's a 3-hour fight.
It's a big-ass turtle.
I did it in 32. Also, fun fact, check this out. I have a portable MP3 player we can play. Alex, what's your favorite Final Fantasy?
9. That's the best Final Fantasy.
Is this 9?
Yeah. It's like a really deep cut. There you go.
Beautiful. So you can listen to your favorite Final Fantasy tracks. Unfortunately, I wish it had every single one.
You
but
know
it does
they're
not.
Gonna, they gotta roll that out. What?
What is that?
What? Oh, I forgot about this.
That thing's like half bird, half storm, half airship.
You realize that's three halves.
Explain its size. Awesome in every sense.
That is to show you that not only are the monsters big, but you will fight them at some point.
It's literally the same thing as Ho-Oh flying over Ash. It's like, get ready for like what crazy bullshit there is in the future.
Yeah. Anyways, what I was saying is I wish that they had more
tracks. I bet you they're gonna like sell that shit.
I don't think so. I wish they were down. You can buy more albums as it goes on.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Well, cause they're adding DLC to the game, right?
If they add more, I'm in.
Isn't there two DLCs coming? At least?
There's at least
two paid ones.
Four more DLC updates.
You know that they're gonna add music each time. You know it.
It's only so far a man can walk.
Because some people will pay it just for the music.
Pretend you're walking to the car.
Can you imagine seeing four guys running that close together? Like practically touching elbows? Like running towards a gas station together?
Right.
Like, are they gonna kill us? What is happening here? They're running really weird.
Yeah, they're really...
They're all dressed like not unified. Is that guy on his way to a prom? Oh.
Yo, they restored to my old colors. What the fuck?
Hilarious.
Oh no, it's the special edition.
Oh, it's the
edition.
Sexy version. Too pretty for the road. Definitely. That car's definitely too pretty for
She's
the road.
Back. We should all get a picture with her.
Look at Prompto's eyes, dude.
There's a reason why his eyes are that way, and that's why I'm not feeding into your theory.
Whatever.
So the four characters specialize.
Mind making a little delivery for me?
Yes, absolutely.
No, not at all.
No way.
Thought you'd say yes, so I already put it in the trunk. There should be a motel on your way to Galden. If y'all wouldn't mind giving that to the owner, that'd be swell.
Oh yeah, so this is another big departure from the other Final Fantasies, is that in this game, instead of getting experience after every battle, you sort of like set it aside instead of applying it to yourself. So every time you kill monsters, you still get experience, but you don't gain the experience till you go to sleep.
Yeah.
So you sleep outdoors and you can eat food around the campfire, and the food is like Monster Hunter. You like get a boost for your next time out. And that's kind of like the cycle. But what pretty much everybody does is they sleep at hotels because the nicer the place is that you sleep, the bigger the multiplier is on your experience. So that's actually a really cool thing. But it's like, you know, if you want to put in the time, if you really want to like grind for a long time at the same level, you can like leap forward in level by like gaining money and doing hunts and stuff. And it's awesome. It just like lets you kind of like choose how you want to plan your day.
These are the new decals we just got.
Oh my god.
Platinum Levion came with the version that I got. This is a new one I got too.
Wow, that
is golden chocobo.
So gaudy.
The Cindy Mobile.
This is just like
Dear
a NASCAR.
God.
This is just like a NASCAR car.
How about the
carbuncle sticker set?
This is
anything you
Guardians.
Like. Oh my god. These are so weird.
The Beast.
Anything you like?
God, these look so
the
weird.
Anything you
How
like?
About the decals?
Oh, it's the crow from
the crow's
nest.
It's like an anime about
the
crow.
Yeah. I think they're different colors because of the current colors that I have.
How about the decals?
How about the decals?
Yeah, that's my current color set. I tend to
pick a color.
My favorite color that I usually do.
I'm afraid we're missing.
Do I not have?
Things.
Oh, I never. I guess I never got these. I could have sworn I bought these
I'm
before.
Afraid we're missing some things.
Huh?
Or maybe. Oh.
You need,
yeah.
You need like materials.
Yeah. I usually do this, crimson. Crimson is my color.
Usually what I do for my regalia is I just leave it the color that it is, and I just change the interior to tan. That's like what I like the regalia to look like. Yours is like a little sportier.
Yeah.
It's like classy, but it's sporty. Like a Porsche.
Oh yeah, all this shit's here. Sweet. So you get special upgrades in the game later as it goes on.
Yeah.
They
like make the car like waste less gas, like.
Yeah, at this point, I think I have infinite gas installed.
Gas?
Yeah, so we don't have to ever stop worrying about gas, I think. Also, I have the enhanced headlights so we can drive in the evenings.
Without running into monsters.
They'll be scared of the car.
How's this? Y'all just
That is
now.
Awesome.
Pretty crazy,
get,
yeah.
When do you get that?
It's a side quest.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
I'm gonna get that immediately.
It's all ready for you. Have a look.
It would make my gameplay so much more efficient.
Right. Anyways, well, we have a lot to talk about in this game. Hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Let's fucking get right to it, Al.
Yeah, we're just gonna keep talking about
shit. I called you Al. I'm so sorry, Al.
Phone call for Al. Alcoholic. I don't think so, Tim.
I don't think so, Tim. Next time on Beer Bros, we're gonna fucking fuck shit up as always. Don't fuck with the Beer Bros.
Yep.
Don't.
Bop.
Bye.